Back to STS. In today's video, we need to find the area under the curve f of x is equal to x cubed over the interval 1, 2. This here is a definite integration problem, or a definite integral problem. Place my integration symbol, my interval, lower bound is 1, the upper bound is 2, and the function that I'm going to integrate is x cubed dx. All right, to do this integration, I know that I need to increment the power from 3 to 4, and I also increment the denominator to that same power of 4. And in this square bracket notation, I again show the interval from 1 to 2. And what I need to do now is make my substitution, where I'm first going to substitute in the upper boundary, which is 2. Oops, let me go back. The upper boundary, which is 2, where that's raised to the fourth power over 4, minus the lower boundary, which is 1 raised to the fourth power over 4, and then I evaluate. Well, 2 times 2, well, 2 to the fourth, 2 times 2 was 4, and 2 times 2 was 4 again, so 4 times 4 tells me this here has to be 16. So I have 16 fourths minus 1 to the fourth power, which is 1. Again, over 4. And then from here, I can simplify. I have 16 divided by 4 to give me 4. So I end up with 14 minus 1 fourth, which actually turns out to be 3 and 75 hundredths, because I know that 1 fourth is 25 hundredths. And if I subtract that off, I end up with 3 and 75 hundredths. Alright, and that there is the area underneath the curve. So this here is in square units. Now let's pull up the calculator and let's verify this result. Alright, I begin by pressing the y equals button, and you see I already have the x cubed function in place. Let's go ahead and click graph, and we see our cubic function is drawn. We need to go from x being 1 to 2, so I know we're going to be in this first quadrant, so let's just zoom in on that area. So alpha and then math to pull up. Whoops, let's go back. Graph. I need to hit zoom first, and then I'm going to press alpha and A to give me the first quadrant. And I want to zoom in some more, so let's go to window. And for the window, I'm going to make my x maximum be, let's say, 3. And I'm going to make my y maximum be a 9. And then from here, I press graph again. And now I have a nice close-up of the area that I want to look at. Now let's click or press on second and then trace to get to the integration function, which is down here at number 7. And the lower limit for this problem was 1. So I press enter. And then my upper limit was 2. And I press enter again, and notice how it shades in that region, and we see that the integration over that interval comes out to be 3 and 75 hundredths, which is the same thing we calculated by hand. And here in square brackets, we see that the interval is also the same. Well, that sums it up for this video by Speller Tutorial Services. Please friend us on Facebook and also subscribe to that YouTube channel, and as always, thank you for watching.